this video, I'll be talking about different elements of mise-en-scène in regard to a sequence from the series Better Call Saul. Mise-en-scène is a French term meaning what is put into a scene. It can refer to a number of different visual elements, but ultimately functions to communicate important information or emotions to the audience. However, I'll mostly be talking about the setting, framing, props, and the use of lighting and colour in Better Call Saul, and what effect this has on the audience. The sequence begins by showing the main character, Saul Goodman, working at a cinnamon cafe, having assumed a new identity and leaving his life as a corrupt lawyer behind him. He's living under the radar, which is initially highlighted by his lack of presence in the scene. The focus seems to be more on the production of the cinnamon rolls and how procedural, mundane and dull the whole thing seems, which is further conveyed by the black and white. The scene is completely devoid of colour but for shades of grey, which also has a fairly depressing effect. Saul is rarely central in the shot, except for in this scene where he feels threatened. He fears that somebody has learnt his true identity, and as the man approaches, Saul becomes central in the shot, showing he is focal. How could I be? But he has made a mistake in assuming the man was looking at him, and as the man passes Saul, Saul moves from the centre of the frame again, assuming his usual unimportant role. This represents Saul's anxious state of mind, his paranoia, and conveys that he is clearly unhappy. There is a sense of depression in the scene, as other camera techniques, such as wide-angle shots, make him appear small and highlight his feelings of insignificance and a lack of self-worth. The formal and procedural elements of his workplace seem to extend to his personal life, as Saul's home looks devoid of character. There are no pictures or personal possessions or knick-knacks lying around his house, and it comes across as unusually tidy and doesn't seem permanent. It doesn't look like it's been lived in. The furniture is arranged in an oddly formal and impersonal way, and the deco appears in-fitting with styles of the 1970s or 80s. Similarly, in this shot, Saul looks very small and insignificant once again, just like he did in the previous scene at work. All these factors contribute to convey Saul's emotional state of despair, depression, and lack of identity. The 70s deco shows he's living in the past. He hasn't adjusted to a new identity, and as a result, he has no identity, which is reflected by his cold-looking house.
We know this because that's what it says on the back where the Certificate of Authenticity is located. Just as lovely as can be, look at the soft, delicate shading, very feminine. This is a limited...
Only his head is visible in this unusually wide shot, which gives the impression that he's hiding. There is also a strange amount of emphasis on the furniture in the foreground, which seems to dominate the shot. This makes him look unimportant and tiny, but also have the effect of making the surroundings look huge, empty, and fairly lonely. This is emphasised by the table and the chairs in the foreground. There are two chairs and an empty, derelict table. Why would he need two chairs for one person? Why does he have a sofa when he clearly only uses one chair? This represents his loneliness and shows that he has lost somebody. He wasn't always alone, and the chairs in the foreground represent abandoned hope. The lack of homeliness of the room makes him look out of place, and somehow quite awkward and uncomfortable. Once again, Saul, in addition to appearing tiny, is off-centre, and what seems to be the focus of the shot is one of the empty chairs, which represents emptiness, further emphasised by the overall setting, and reflects Saul's emotional state of occupying an empty life, like an empty house, out of place, out of his depth, and feeling unfulfilled. In this next shot, Saul is partially obscured by something out of focus and in the foreground, continuing with the visual representation that he's hiding. The majority of the shot is dominated by just black, which shows that Saul's life is shrouded with darkness. Only his head remains on the surface. He's being consumed and must escape before he drowns in his sorrow. This shows that his current life is unsustainable, as he is trapped, but needs a way out. The darkness that dominates the shot, consuming Saul, might also suggest depth to his character, as well as that he's hiding. He only appears as a face on the surface, but what lies beneath, covered by darkness and depleted of light, is his true self, which he keeps hidden away somewhere. In a shoebox, to be precise. Once again, the vertical blinds give the impression of a prison cell, and his facial expression bears a look of anxiety, stress, and unhappiness. His breath on the windowpane suggests that the scene is very cold, with the black and white also conveying this well, and this represents Saul's emotional state well. He is cold and numb. This also makes his face less visible, concealing his identity, representing both the fact that he's hiding and running, as well as that he has lost himself. As we have seen so far, Saul is surviving in a false identity and not living his life. It's destroying him, so in this scene, he escapes mentally by watching a video of his old law advertisements.
Don't let false allegations bully you into an unfair fight.
The tape embodies his old life. He keeps it hidden away, but it's imperative that he returns to it. It's his only escape from his everyday act, his menial routine. In this shot, as he watches his old self, he is out of focus, but the wall behind him is. And one gap in the blinds leading him to the outside world is almost central in the shot and stands out in terms of composition. This represents the risk he is taking. He could be seen and somebody could find out, but also represents his escape. There is one chink of light in the blinds, one forbidden way out. As the scene progresses, Saul becomes in focus because he is not lost anymore. He is found. He has found himself once again, and he is exposed. There is no darkness consuming him and dominating the shot, just like before, and he is completely illuminated by the strong light of the TV. As his image comes into focus, so does his true identity. In this next shot, Saul is completely in focus and central. He once again feels important as he assumes his old identity, but he is only able to look upon it and reflect. However, there is also a sense of hopelessness, as whilst he is central, he is framed by darkness, trapped, but as the camera zooms in, he becomes larger, occupying more of a shot, whilst the darkness becomes smaller, less significant. The lighting is interesting here, as the left half of his face is lit up. It gives the impression that he is broken. He's split in two, only half a person, and at conflict with himself. But what is interesting in this scene is that it's not devoid of colour as the rest of the sequence is. Here, reflected in his glasses, is the colour red. This is showing how his old life is the only light he has left in a dark world, the only beacon of hope in this hopeless situation. What is also interesting is that this sequence is set in the present, whereas the rest of the series is set far in the past. This sequence is after the events in Breaking Bad, whereas the rest is set long before Breaking Bad. However, whilst this is completely black and white, the rest of the series, which is Saul's past, is shot in vibrant colour. This is unusual as it seems backwards. This shows that his past is the only bright time in his life, a better place. Red is also known to represent love and passion, which is why red is reflected back in his glasses. The red represents his old life, his passion, and his loved ones and old self. The tape is his escape from prison. He's trapped with no way out.